Hi friends, welcome to Chetana Pixel YouTube channel. Today's topic is how to filter rows and columns in MS Excel using the filter function, which is introduced in Office 365 and the later versions. Filter is a dynamic function. We can narrow down the results as we supply the criteria. If anybody wanted to know more details to use the filter function in basic levels, please check out my channel that I have made two basic videos on filter function. The same videos links I have provided in the description also. You can check it out. I have here process wise headcount details. Extract these details from any data source like SQL or any other data source platforms. I will get more columns, but for my reporting purpose, I may not need all these details. Let's say I need employee ID, industry, and the country, and the status, and these three columns: status, production headcount, and supporting headcount. Let me copy and paste into L5 cell. I have copied. So let's see how to filter first automotive from Lenovo client using filter. First, we need to select the entire data range. And then comma. And then wherever we wanted to filter, that column we need to select. Industry equals to automotive, and then close bracket, and one multiplication symbol, and then open another bracket, and the client column also we need to select, only the data range without headers, equals to Lenovo, then close two times brackets and hit enter. It filters all the details pertaining to Lenovo and automotive, irrespective of columns we specify on the top. This means these many records are there in the entire data. It returned all the columns here. So we wanted to narrow down to these many columns. So let's start. So first, what we have to do, we need to make one small helper row on top of the headers, which identifies to filter these many columns. For that, we need only zeros and ones. So let me put manually now. First, I need to include employee ID, client name I don't want, industry I need, process I don't want, and country we need to include, city not required, status is required, and production headcount required. Supporting headcount is required. So now how to filter? So this is, let's say this is an inner filter. For this filter, we need to add another outer filter. Filter, comma, whatever the results comes through this filter, we need to filter out the columns. This column equals to 1. If you look at our results, these are the columns that we require. You may be thinking that how to identify this row, these zeros and ones. There is a simple formula I will explain you using the match lookup value is the header A5 cell, comma. We need to match the headers here. For safer side, instead of Q5, I'm changing to Z5, which means if we include in future any other additional column, that also will get updated automatically, comma 0. This function returns the column's position. Sorry, it's my bad. I need to freeze this range. Press Control enter. So the column position of employee ID in our result data set is 1. Similarly, industry is 2. Similarly, country is 3. So we need to change this result into zeros or ones. It's very simple. If is error of this match function, put 0, else 1. Hit enter. Then copy the same function to across the all the headers. So now wherever it was NA error, it will change to zeros. Wherever there was a number, it will change to ones. So now we don't have any issue. This will filter based on the zeros and ones, and the results will be updated. So let's say I want, instead of country, I want the process. Let's change to process. This will bring the process. So this is how you can use to filter down the rows and the columns as well. So when we have the criteria across the columns, that means multiple columns, we can use multiplication symbol. You can see here C6 to C35, which is industry is equal to L2, automotive I have given. At the same time, in another column, I am giving one more condition, L3. L3 is Lenovo as client name. I am giving another column. So these two criteria are from two different columns. When our criteria is from two different columns, we have to give multiplication symbol. I want to include here manufacturing into industry. So how to give the criteria? Because this manufacturing is from the same industry column. So what I have to do, just open another bracket and close the industry criteria, use a plus symbol and open another bracket. Again, you need to select the industry column equals to M2 cell and then close. Make sure you have one more bracket outside for the same columns criteria and then hit enter. So now if you look at the results, earlier there were 4 records, now there are 5 records for Lenovo, automotive and manufacturing. Both have been included into the result set. At the same time, we have only 6 headers. So this is how you can furthermore or narrow down your results using plus and the multiplication symbol in the filter function. Suppose if you want to sort by industry, the same results can also be sorted by industry. You can use the sort outside, sort whatever the result came up, sort index, which based on which column you wanted to sort. I wanted to sort by second column. Second, what is the sort order? You want to sort by ascending or descending order? Let me go by ascending order. You can see all automotive came to the top and manufacturing gone down. So this is how we can use a filter and sort function combination. If anybody wanted to know more details to use the filter function in basic levels, please check out my channel. That I have made 2 basic videos on filter function. The same videos links I have provided in the description also. You can check it out. Thank you so much for watching my video. Hope this will be helpful in your daily work. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. See you in the next video.